Hello everyone, welcome to Ade's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how I make this lovely croaker fish stew, which I'm going to enjoy with my homemade pounded yam, which you are going to see in my next video how I prepared it. For my four medium croakers, I'm going to be using 2 canned tomatoes, 4 raw tomatoes, 3 scotch bonnets, 2 slices of ginger, 2 cloves of garlic, and 1 medium onion, 100 ml of palm oil, 4 nut cubes. Then I'm going to defrost my frozen fish under cold running water for 20 minutes or more. Continue running cold water over the fish. Then cut all the gills and the fins of the fish with fish scissors. Descale the fish with the tip of a small knife, or you can use the descaler if you have one. Descale properly. Descale the fish by using the tip of a small knife, or if you have a descaler, you can use your descaler, but I'm using my small knife. Then I'm going to cut my fish into my preferred size. I'm cutting mine into 3-3, and the small one I'm going to cut it into 2. Wash the fish under cold running water. Remove the brain of the fish. Use the tip of the finger to scrub inside the fish. I'm using the tip of my finger to scrub inside the fish properly so that it will be properly clean. Scrub and rinse inside the water. Then I'm going to use another clean water to finally clean the fish. Then I'm going to add the fish into the strainer to drain all the water before adding the seasoning. Then I'm adding 2 teaspoons of salt, 1 teaspoon of white pepper, and some black pepper. Crush in some black pepper. Then mix everything properly well together and set aside. Flip over and mix properly. I've washed the peppers and I'm adding it to the blender. Add the canned tomatoes and use some water to rinse the can and add it to the blender. Add everything together, the garlic, the ginger, the onion, and cover and blend. Blend the pepper till it's smooth. Add the palm oil to the pan. Just heat it up for like 2 minutes, not bleaching. Then add the onion. Add the blended pepper. Then I'm going to use another small amount of water to rinse my blender and add it to the pot. I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of tomato puree. Using tomato puree to cook your fish is going to improve the quality of the stew, then add more taste. I made mistake of using tomato puree to cook my fish one day, and at the end of the cooking, it was so lovely. Since then, I've been using tomato puree to cook my fish. And cook for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, open. Stir the sauce and mix properly. Make sure it's properly mixed. Then add the seasoning. After adding the seasoning, cover for another 5 minutes. open and stir. Mix it properly before adding the fish. Stir the sauce properly. Make sure it's properly mixed. Stir it properly before adding the fish. Then I'm adding all the head of the fish first because they cook longer than the tail and the middle. After adding all the fish, shake the pot. Cover to cook for 12 minutes. After 12 minutes, open, shake, and taste for more salt. The fish stew is almost ready. My fish stew is ready to serve now, and I'm going to enjoy this with okra and my homemade pounded yam, which I'm going to show you how I prepared it in my next video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and share with your loved ones. May God bless you as you do so. Thank you.